All of you, welcome to the session. Department of Collegiate and Technical Education. Subject is Mission Design 15MBE53T code for 5th sem students. Department of Mechanical Engineering. This is unit number 4. Design of simple machine parts, problems on knuckle joint. This is session number 9. So design of knuckle joint problems we study here. In this session we are briefly discuss about the various different parts of the knuckle joint, how to design a knuckle joint and what are the failures and what are the particular point will be checking and every session. So this is the problem number 1. Design a knuckle joint to transmit 150 kilonewton. The design stress may be taken as a 75 megapascal in tension and 60 megapascal in shear and 150 megapascal in compression. So once again I will repeat the question. Observe carefully. Design a knuckle joint to transmit 150 kilonewton. So 150 kilonewton is in a load. The design stress may be taken as 75 megapascal in tension. Tension is 75 megapascal and 60 megapascal in shear and 150 megapascal in compression. So this is the question. We go for solution. So write down or observe the given data. Their P is equal to 150 kilonewton. This is the given value is 150 kilonewton. Convert into newtons. Therefore 150 into 10 raised to power 3 newtons. Kilo means 1000. So here 10 raised to power 3, write down here. Then sigma t, tensile stress is equal to 75 megapascal. 75 megapascal or 75 newton per mm square are both are same. Megapascal or newton mm per is both are same. Is in a tensile stress. And shear stress, tau is equal to 60 megapascal. Is equal to 60 newton per mm square is in shear. Shear stress and sigma c is equal to 150 megapascal. 150 into newton per mm square is equal to crushing stress. So let us see the knuckle joint step by step. So we go for first one is design of knuckle rod. The failure of the rod in tension. Let d is equal to diameter of the rod. We are find here diameter of the rod. We know that the load transmitted P we have. Formula P is equal to pi by 4 d square into sigma t. From data handbook in page number 67. So equation number is 4.19a. So observe the equation here. Then substitute the values of load and tensile stress in the above equation and calculate the value of d. Then what is the p value? P is equal to 150 kilonewton is equal to pi by 4 into d square into 75. Sigma t is equal to 75 and p is equal to 150 into 10 raised to power 3. Then check out the values. Then calculate d is equal to square root of 150 into 10 raised to power 3 into 4 all divided by pi into 75. So the d value is 50.4 mm. So 50.4 mm is in a decimal numbers. You can round off into the higher even number, means round off into the bigger number, means the diameter of the number rod is equal to d is equal to 52 mm. So round up the values. Then we go for dimensions of various parts of the knuckle joint. We can calculate each and every one with the knuckle joint. You can easily substitute the values. If the d is the diameter of the rod, already we know that the value d is equal to 52. The diameter of the pin, delta or d is equal to 52. So same, delta or d is equal to, both are the same. The outer diameter of the eye, capital D is equal to 2 times of small d. Small d is equal to 52 value, then substitute 2 into times. So therefore the capital D is equal to 104. The diameter of the knuckle pin head and collar, C value, this is the fourth one. C is equal to 1.5 times of D. Then 1.5 into 52, therefore C value is equal to 78. Then fifth value, the thickness of the single eye or rod end, F is equal to 1.5 times of D. So therefore the value is same, 1.5 into 52, therefore the value is 78. F is equal to 78. Then sixth value, thickness of the fork, B is equal to 0.75 D. Then 0.75 into 52, then approximately we are 39, so round off into 40. The seventh value is thickness of the pin head, he is equal to 0.5 D, is equal to 26. So is equal to 26 value. Then eighth one is thickness of the square section, S1 is equal to S, both are same, therefore equation is 1.2 into D, therefore substitute the values 1.2 into 52, therefore 62.4. so 62.4 is the decimal numbers, you can go for higher number, therefore 64. Then ninth one is collar diameter, C is equal to 1.5 D, so 1.5 into 52, therefore value is 78. Then we go for 11th one, collar thickness, he is equal to 0.5 D, is equal to 26. 12th one is taper pin, solid or split, is equal to G is equal to 6 mm, so it is 3 by 16 D to 1 divided by 4 D. So in this range we can get the values, therefore G is equal to 6 mm. Distance is equal to H is equal to 0.8 into D, then substitute the D value, then we get the value is 42. The thickness of the sections across the fork, A is equal to 0.6 into D, then value is 32. The distance from high end to the center of the pin, L is equal to 4 times of D, is equal to 0.8. Then distance between L is equal to 1.5 into 2, 2D. So range varies from 1.5D to 2 times of D, therefore value is 104. 17th value is distance from the center to the fork end, L1 is equal to 4.8 into D, therefore 4.8 into, substitute the 52 value, therefore we get the value of 250. This is the various parts of the knuckle joint. Then give it for second one is failure of the knuckle pin in shear. Since the pin is in double shear, therefore the load P is equal to 2 into pi by 4 D1 square into tau. Tau means shear stress. So from the above equation, check the induced stresses. In this equation, we are find out the shear stress value. Therefore, tau is equal to P into 4 divided by pi into 2 into D1 square. Therefore, substitute all the values here and check the shear stress value. Therefore, tau is equal to 150 into 10 raised to power 3 into 4 all divided by 5 into 2 into 50 square. Therefore, tau is equal to 35.3 Newton per mm square. So this is the tau value, 35.3 Newton per, this is the value is round off. Then we go for third one is failure of the single eye or rod end in tension. The single eye or rod end may be tear off due to the tensile load. we do that the load P is equal to P is equal to D minus D small d1 into F into sigma T. From this equation that induced tensor stress sigma T for the single I rod or end may be checked. In this case, the induced tensor stress is more than the allowable working stress, then increase the outer diameter of the high. Therefore, D is checking the value of tensor stress. Therefore, the equation sigma T is equal to P divided by capital D minus D1 into F. We know the value of P. P is equal to 150 into 10 raised to power 3 whole divided by, so capital D value is 104 minus D1 small d1 is equal to 52 into what is the FL is 78. Then substitute all the values here and find the value sigma T tensor stress. We get the tensor stress value is 36.9 Newton per mm square. So round of the answer. Then we go for fourth one. Failure of the single I or rod end in shearing. So previous one is we are checking for tensile. Here is we are checking for shearing. Then the single I or rod end may fail in the shearing due to the tensile load. We know that the value of P. So P is equal to capital D minus small d1 into F into tau. Tau means shear stress. From this equation, the induced shear stress tau is for the single I or rod end may be checked. Therefore, tau is equal to 150 into 10 raised to power 3 whole divided by 104 minus 52 into 78. The tau value is 36.9 Newton per mm square. Then round up the fourth value. Then we go for fifth one is failure of the single I or rod end in crushing. The single I or pin may be fail in the crushing due to the tensile load. We know that the value of P. So P value, the equation P is equal to D1 into F into sigma C. From this equation, the induced crushing stress sigma C for the single I or pin may be checked in case the induced crushing stress is more than the allowable working stress, then the increase the thickness of the single I F value. Therefore, sigma C is equal to P divided by D1 into F. Then sigma C is equal to 150 into 10 raised to power 3 whole divided by 52 into 78. Then the value of sigma C is equal to 36.9 Newton per mm square. So observe here, failure of the single I in tensile stress and crushing stress and shear stress, we get the same values sigma C, sigma T and tau is equal to, we get the same values 36.9 Newton per mm square. So we go for sixth one is failure of the forked end in tension. The forked end or double I may be fail in the tension due to the tensile load. We know that the load P is equal to equation P is equal to capital D minus small d1 into 2 times of B into sigma T. From this equation, the induced tensile stress for forked end may be checked. Sigma T is equal to P divided by capital D minus small d1 into 2 times of B. Then sigma T is equal to 150 into 10 raised to power 3 whole divided by 104 minus 52 into 2 times of into 40. Therefore, the value is sigma T is equal to 36.9 Newton per mm square. Then we go for the seventh, checking for failure of the forked end in shear. The forked end may be fail in the shearing due to this tensile load. We know that the load P, P is equal to capital D minus D1 into 2 times of B into shear tau. From this equation, the induced shear stress for the forked end may be checked. In case of the induced stresses is more than the allowable working stress, then thickness of the fork is increased. Then tau is equal to 150 into 10 raised to 4 3 whole divided by 104 minus 52 into 2 into b. So b value is 40. Then substitute the all the values here and check the shear stress. Therefore shear stress is equal to 36.05 newton per mm square. Round of the values. So we go for eighth one, checking for failure of the fork could end in crushing due to crushing. So first one we go for checking the tensile and shearing, and now is checking for crushing. The forked end or pin may fail in the crushing due to the tensile load. We know that the load P is equal to D1 into 2 times of B into sigma C. So substitute the all the values here. From this equation, the induced crushing stress per the forked end may be checked. Then sigma C is equal to P divided by D1 into 2 times of B. Therefore, P is equal to 150 into 10 raised to power 3 whole divided by 52 into 2 into B. So all the values substitute the here and checking the sigma C means crushing stress. So therefore, crushing stress is equal to 36.05 newton per mm square. So observe the all the values here. So in this observe the clearly, then the conclusion is, since the induced stresses are less than the given design stresses, therefore the joint is safe. Therefore the knuckle joint is safe. Okay, we go for mental checking questions, multiple choice questions. So observe the question here and answer yourself. So go for question number one. In steam engine, valve rod is connected to an eccentric rod by means of, once again I will repeat the question. In steam engine, valve rod is connected to an eccentric rod by means of. So observe the question and choose your right answer. Your options here: option A, quarter joints; option B, knuckle joints; option C, universal joint; option D, bearing. So answer your question. So think and answer. Thinking yourself, check your answers. Okay, keep in your mind your answers. Keep in your mind. I will check the cross check in your end of the session. I will go for second question. So question number two. In of the following, which part of the knuckle joint is important? In, once again I will repeat the question. In of the following, which part of the knuckle joint is important? Option A, pin; option B, eye; option C, fork; option D, all above part is important. So thinking the answers and guess the right answers and neatly observe the question and think your answers and keep in your mind in this answers. I'll cross check in the end of the session. I will go for third question. Question number three. Knuckle joint is cannot used for the transmission. I will repeat the question once again. Knuckle joint is cannot used for torque transmission. Whether it is options true, option number B false, true or false in this question. So guess your answers and keep in your mind and we'll check the end of the session the key answers. We go for fourth question. Knuckle joint is used for connecting two rods whose axis coincided or intersect and lie in the same plane. I will repeat the question and carefully observe here.
Knuckle joint is used for connecting two rods whose axes coincided or intersect and lie in the same plane. So whether it is answers two options, one is A, true, option B is false. True or false question. So guess the answers. Keep in your mind your answers. I will cross check. Okay, we'll go for fifth question. Question number 5. The diameter of the knuckle pin in a knuckle joint is usually taken as, where D is the diameter of the rod. In we are going for checking the diameter of the rod. So observe the question. The diameter of the knuckle pin in knuckle joint is usually taken as. So options here, option number A, 0.5 D, option number B, 0.8 D, and option C, D, and option D is equal to 1.2 times of D. So guess your answers. So I will check your answers, key answers, check in your mind. So key answers, question number 1 for answer is option B. For question number 2, option is D, and question number 3, option is A, and question number 4, option is A, and question number 5, option is C. This is the correct answers. So cross check in your questions. So this is the end of this session. Thank you, one and all. We'll meet in next session. Thank you.